Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. We glorify the Lord Jesus because of this hour that the Lord has given us. We know well that Jesus is our Lord and our Savior, and He is the one who gives us even the time and the periods and the dispensation that we are living of the last days. Because we are living in the last days and Jesus Christ is coming. But He wants us to be holy, to be pure, even in everything that we do. And He wanted to be good example so that others can copy this example. So the teaching I'm teaching is about the result of being example to others and being the light. Jesus came like a human, like human in this world. He walked among men and He brought the image of God to this world. By His characters, by everything He did, we saw Jesus Christ. We saw God in walking like a man. Even so, those who are born again Christian should also bring the image of Jesus in this world. Those who are born again, those who claim they are born again, they are believers, they need even them to bring the image of Jesus in this world. Jesus called us the light of the world. He called us the light of the world so that we may be right to this darkness world. He also called us the salt to give taste to this world. We are the example to this dead world. We are the example to this dead world in sin. God wants His people to be at front line, showing the world the right way. In everything you must be a good example. In everything you do, you must be a good example. In your walking, in your action, in your speaking, in your behaving, you must be a mirror of the truth, which the world can look at and see their fault and see their problem. You must be the mirror of the truth, a mirror of righteousness, a mirror of holiness, so that when they see you, they will see their problem because you are the mirror. But Christians have lost that salt, they have lost that right. Christians should not be copying the worldly people, but instead they should be copied by the world, or they should be imitated by the world, but not Christian imitating the world. This is the hour to be a good example to this perishing world. This is the best hour to be a good example, to be the light of the world. Light now. The word of God says in the book of 1 Timothy 4:12 that do not let anyone look down on you because you are young, but be an example for the believers in your speech, in your conduct, in your love, in your faith, and in your purity. The Bible says that we should be a good example. Don't let anyone look down on you because you are young or old, but be an example for the believers in your speech, in your conduct, in your love, in your faith, in your purity. All those things, you must be good example so that they may see Christ in you. The reason why churches are falling and even losing the right is because they have copied the world and allowed the priest of darkness to rule over them. The enemy has taken over Christian today, that they want to copy the enemy instead of copying Jesus. The enemy has taken over the Christian today because they want now to copy the things of the enemy, the materialistic things, instead of copying Jesus. Following the things of this world is like following a bride man who is going to fall very soon. That is why God is saying that we are not supposed to be following the world. We are supposed to be following Jesus. Look, those who want to serve Lord must follow Jesus and be example to this world. If you don't show your right, then the enemy will show darkness. If you don't show the right or be the light, then the enemy will darken you with the darkness. If you don't preach to the world, then the world will preach for you. The world will preach for you what is evil. The world will preach for you what is evil and unclean your heart because you don't preach for them. If you don't be an example to this world, be careful, because the world will be an example to you. Do you know that since the day you believed Jesus, you became an example to be copied by the world? Since the day you accepted Jesus, you became an example to be copied by the world. There is many people who are following you behind, and those people are taking your every step. They are taking your example. But the question is, where are you leading those people? Hell or heaven? Our action and deeds are recorded both in heaven and in earth for others to follow. The question is, where are you leading many people, those who are following you, following your modest, following your talking, following your walking, following your life of dressing, following your life of going and doing things? Are you leading them to hell or are you leading them to heaven? Our action and deeds are always recorded both in heaven and in earth for others to follow. One time we were going in our missions, we decided to shortcut at the field barefoot, and we shortcutted the road. We followed another route, which was a large field. The journey was long, but we were finding the way out. We found ourselves stuck at the muddy place and water ahead of us. We tried to find our way, but we continued even to get lost. The more we continued to find our way, the more we get lost in that place. We finally decided to go back to the main road. We finally decided to go back to the crossroad, to the main road. The main road, after wasting our time in the long path. Then we noted that behind us we saw a man who was following us on the long way. He struggled also to get the way out until he went back to the main path. We felt mercy and much guilty because that man followed us thinking we were right. He saw that we were there, we were in front of him, and we knew the way, but he followed us. Now, we led him astray like a blind man. We felt condemned. Then the Lord warned us at that time that we must be careful with what we do, because many people are following us. Many eyes are looking and watching over our steps. If we go against the step of God, then even those people will go against the step of God. At this hour, many people has entered to the long path simply because they are following their leaders or their pastors who are teaching them long. Many followed the long path and now they are in muddy place without any direction. Now they are stuck in those pits without any direction. They are now hopeless, discouraged, don't know where to go or what to do next. Now, your life is an example of good or bad, and whatever we do, we are preaching good or bad. Your life is an example of good or bad, and whatever we do, either you are preaching, either you are speaking, either you are eating, either you are walking, either you are dressing, you are preaching good or bad. You are preaching heaven or hell. In the book of Luke 17:2, the Bible says this. The book of Luke 17:2, it says, it would be better for them to be thrown into the sea with a millstone tied around their neck than to cause one of those little ones to stumble. You see, Jesus said when he said this in a very emotional way and very serious way, that it would be better for them to be thrown into the sea with a millstone tied around their neck than to cause one of those little ones to stumble. One of those innocent people to stumble. And when we watch at the world today, the little ones are stumbling. The little ones are led astray by the people who are older than them. Jesus warned that those who will lead astray his children will be better be hanged and be cast to that sea, which is the sea of the lake of fire. It is very hurting when somebody is leading astray millions innocent souls. It is very hurting when somebody is one soul is leading astray millions innocent souls. Here, your life is an example to lead astray the young ones or to save them. Whatever you do here in earth, you are preaching to somebody. If you wear half naked or tight clothes, exposing your body, you are leading astray many people who are watching you. They will follow and like your immoral dressing. See, they will rust at you. They will be uncleaned even their mind. Why? Because you have opened the door to sin. You will be cast to the ocean, the hell, because of leading astray the young ones. You put fake hairs. You dye and paint your hair. Now Jesus is saying that you must repent and stop leading others to others astray. Whatever you are doing, you are either increasing hell or increasing heaven. Is your life leading many to holiness of God or leading many to hell? Are you drinking? Are you smoking? Whatever you are doing, you are showing others the way. Somebody will watch you, and somebody will love to do what you are doing, because simply maybe you are older than that man, that he. Now, is your life leading many to holiness of God or leading many to hell? The Bible says, for whatever you plant, you shall harvest. Be careful of what you wear or how you speak, because you are mounted higher for somebody to copy you. You are mounted higher, like a house planted or built at the mountain, for everyone to see. That is what you are. What are you copied? Are you copied good or bad? What are they imitating you? Are they imitating you to do good or to do bad? If you have been leading astray and uncleaning the minds of people by your immoral clothes, half-naked fashions, and even those drinking, smoking, and even speaking evil, repent and stop it now, because great judgment will strike you more than others. The wrath of God is upon you. The wrath of God is greater. Even the judgment is upon those who mislead others by their doings. The wrath and the greater judgment is upon those who mislead even others by their doings. One time I was at the meeting of revival, and when it was over, thousand were inside the field. Many thousand people were inside the field, and they started departing around. They started departing in a wrong caravans to the road. Then I saw a woman breaking up a wall and penetrating through the wall and making a hole there, a loophole for other people to come and to join and to walk through that loophole. There she builded a hole, and all those who are following her also break the wall, and they entered through that hole and started going through the wall to avoid, so that they may avoid even the wrong line. Now all those people, all those people were now sinning because of that, the woman who sinned. Then the Lord said to me, look what is happening. One person leading many to hell when she or he breaks my commandments. I could not imagine that I was seeing with my eyes, because many people, many thousand, they followed that wrong path, that loophole that was created. They followed it, and they were getting lost because of one woman. One person who do wrong can cause many millions in hell. Imagine the one who invented those fake hairs and even coloring hair. Now many are led astray and going to hell. When you start doing evil, you will be used as an instrument of hell, and you will be preaching for hell. You will be winning soul for hell, because you have not accepted Jesus Christ. You don't want to live a holy life. We must stop copying what we see at TV or movies, because today the media is used as a satanic door to enter hell. Even you may see a preacher preaching the media, but she is wearing immoral, she is doing makeups and even fair force hair, and even men, they are piercing their ears and even chemicaling their hair. That does not matter. That person, that preacher is there to preach for hell and to win many souls to hell by showing them how to live a lukewarm life, a 50% believer and a 50% unbeliever in worldly TVs and all those movies, because today the media is used as a satanic door to enter hell. What we watch will direct us to hell or heaven. Children and youth are copying Satan in media, and this is why many children have lost the way of God. They don't have the fear of God in them, because they follow the things of the world. They follow evil. The greater judgment will be for those who lead astray others, and the great reward will be for those who lead others to do good. One man causing millions to hell, and one man causing million to heaven. Which part are you? Are you in the part of one man leading many to hell, or in that part of one man causing many people to enter heaven by the truth, by the good life? Then change your life and start evangelizing and winning soul for Jesus by your conduct, by your behavior, by your speaking, by your wrath, by your speech, by your faith, by your kindness. If you are a preacher of gospel, you must be careful of what you preach and let the word of God back up your teachings. Then you many people, because many have read astray many innocent souls. How many have you read astray since you received Jesus? Or how many have you brought to the kingdom of God since you received Jesus? You are what you are now, and you must be used for good or bad. Be used for hell or for heaven. You are the screen of heaven or the screen of hell by your life and by your deed. Be the light and be a good example to everything. To everything you do, and be a good example to in everything you do, so that you may bring many souls to Jesus. So you are what you are now, and you are the screen of heaven or the screen of hell by what you are doing or displaying in your conducts. The word of God says in the book of Matthew chapter 5 verse 14-16, conclusion: you are like light for the whole world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid. No one lights a lamp and puts it under a bowl. Instead, it is put on the lampstand, where it gives light for everyone in the house. In the same way, your light must shine before people, so that they will see the good things you do and praise your Father in heaven. May you be a good example for Jesus, for there is the reward of being that. Prepare the way. Jesus Christ is coming. Shalom.